journey of vaccine development. A lot of testing is usually done before human trials. Initial steps include laboratory and animal studies. First is the exploratory stage. This stage involves basic laboratory research and often lasts 2 to 4 years. Scientists identify natural or synthetic antigen that might help prevent or treat a disease. These antigens could include virus-like particles, weakened viruses or bacteria, weakened bacterial toxins, or other substances derived from germ. The preclinical stage. Preclinical studies use tissue culture or cell culture systems and animal testing. Animal subjects mostly include mice and a non-human primate like chimpanzee. This stage assesses the safety of the candidate vaccine, the antigen's ability to induce an antibody response, or its immunogenicity and what they might expect in humans. It identifies a safe starting dose for the next phase of research and a safe method or route of administering the vaccine. During this phase, researchers may make minor variation in the vaccine to make it more effective and conduct challenged studies with the animals by vaccinating the animals and then infecting them with the target pathogen. The preclinical stages often last 1 to 2 years. Many candidate vaccines never progress beyond the stage due to non-attainment of the desired targets. Next stage is a phase 1 vaccine trials. Here, the candidate vaccine is tested in small groups of healthy adult humans, usually between 20 to 80 subjects. If the vaccine is intended for children, researchers first test on adults and then gradually step down the age of the test subjects until they reach their target. Phase 1 trials may be non-blinded, also known as open label, wherein the researchers and perhaps the subjects know whether a vaccine or a placebo is used. Goals of phase 1 testing are to assess the safety of the candidate vaccine and to determine the type and extent of immune response that the vaccine provokes. Phase 1 trial, if attained the desired outcomes, will then progress to the next stage, Phase 2 vaccine trials. This is done when situation gets real. Here, several hundreds are tested, and among them, some of the individuals may belong to groups which are at risk of getting the disease. These trials are randomized and well controlled and include a placebo group. This means both the researcher and the subjects do not know if they are getting the vaccine or placebo. The goals of phase 2 trials are to study the candidate's vaccine safety, immunogenicity, proposed doses, schedule of immunizations, and method of delivery. Phase 3 vaccine trials. It involves thousands to tens of thousands of people. These are randomized and double-blind and involve the experimental vaccine being tested against a placebo. The placebo may be a saline solution, a vaccine for another disease, or some other substance. Phase 3 trials aim to assess the vaccine safety in a large group of people, to look for certain rare side effects which might not surface in the smaller groups of subjects tested in earlier phases, and to test the efficacy of the vaccine as well. This might include the questions: does the candidate vaccine prevent disease? Does it lead to production of antibodies or other types of immune responses related to the pathogen? The next steps involve approval and licensure to release the vaccine. Phase 4 trials. Phase 4 trials are optional studies that drug companies may conduct after a vaccine is released. The manufacturer may continue to test the vaccine for safety, efficacy, and other potential uses. So, in total, it takes anywhere between 7 to 15 years for a new vaccine development.